The FAA has announced unexpected regulations limiting launch schedules for aerospace companies. This change could have significant implications for SpaceX. The goal behind this decision is to reduce congestion in the aerospace sector due to the rise in commercial air travel, which could limit SpaceX's ability to conduct frequent launches and hinder the United States' progress in commercial space exploration. Opponents claim the rules are too restrictive because SpaceX already successfully coordinates with air traffic control. Company executives have expressed concerns that the regulations could stifle creativity and advocated for new policies that facilitate routine launches. Suggested alternatives include the use of automated airspace management systems and dedicated launch routes to ensure a balance between safety and progress. How SpaceX and the FAA respond to this situation will shape the next phase of America's space race. Let's discuss all of this in today's episode of NR Studio. It's clear that the aerospace sector has entered a highly competitive period. Competition between leading spacefaring nations and private companies is intensifying, resulting in a rapid increase in the frequency of rocket launches. However, this impressive expansion has recently faced an unexpected challenge due to a recent FAA decision, which can be traced back to the previous extended federal government shutdown. On November 6, the FAA released a notice titled "Prohibition of Commercial Space Launches and Re-entries During Peak Hours." The notice officially stated, "Beginning at 6 a.m. Eastern Time on November 10, 2025, and until this order is rescinded, commercial space launches and re-entries will only be permitted between 10 p.m. Eastern Time and 6 a.m. Eastern Time. This mandate stipulates that commercial civil aviation is prioritized for daytime operations, while all other commercial spaceflight activities are required to occur at night. Furthermore, the number of domestic civil aviation flights has been reduced by approximately 10%, although it is unclear whether the number of aerospace launches will also be reduced under this rule. Before discussing the implications, it is important to understand the reasons behind this significant decision. A primary factor stems from the prolonged government shutdown, which resulted in a large portion of federal employees facing temporary layoffs. Many FAA employees responsible for air traffic control were furloughed or forced to work without compensation. This situation places enormous pressure on the agency's capacity to maintain safe and effective operations. As air traffic delays, employee fatigue, and system overload worsen, the FAA recognizes the need to act quickly to reduce the burden on the system. In the notice, the FAA stated, "While existing measures have reduced the risk, delays are increasing, and further measures are now necessary." The FAA's preliminary analysis of information suggests that the system is under pressure due to ongoing delays and erratic staffing shortages, which are contributing to exhaustion. The risk level is rising further, and the FAA is apprehensive regarding the system's capability to uphold the present operational volume. Consequently, the FAA has concluded that extra measures are essential. Essentially, the agency is striving to oversee a system that is being tested to its boundaries. Although the goal is to uphold safety and alleviate stress for air traffic controllers, the ramifications will certainly have a significant impact on the quickly expanding space sector. To illustrate, this newly imposed limitation effectively reduces the daily launch timeframe by 50%. Launches are now permitted solely between 10 p.m. and 6 a.m., resulting in a theoretical halving of the time available for launches. In practice, the consequences might be even more severe, as most rocket launches have historically taken place during daylight for improved visibility, safety, and operational efficiency. Take SpaceX as a case in point. According to data collected by November 6, the company has executed a total of 581 launches, which includes 559 Falcon 9 missions, 11 Falcon Heavy missions, and 11 Starship missions. When examining the time of day for these launches, the statistics show that 57.6% of Falcon 9 launches, 72.7% of Falcon Heavy launches, and 54.5% of Starship launches take place in daylight. This indicates that the FAA's new policy will significantly impact the majority of the company's missions, particularly the Falcon 9 program, which has the highest frequency of launches.
the Starship initiative will also experience obstacles. Currently, most Starship missions are planned for the late afternoon to ensure better visibility for observation and recovery activities, especially for bringing both stages back to Starbase. Performing these tasks at night poses additional challenges, from visibility issues to logistical and safety concerns related to staffing. The visual experience of rocket launches will also be compromised under this new regulation. Launches at night, while impressive in their own right, hinder engineers, analysts, and the audience from observing crucial information. While the brilliant exhaust flames may illuminate the night sky, vital visual data such as the launch moment, stage separation, and booster landing becomes more challenging to capture and evaluate. For both fans and experts, the wonder of seeing a rocket rise against the bright blue sky will be overshadowed by brief flashes of light in the darkness. Additionally, the new time constraints disrupt the working rhythms of thousands of engineers, technicians, and operators who will now need to transition to night shifts. Launch crews will have to accommodate irregular work schedules, which might increase fatigue and complicate mission preparations.
This might hinder advancements, decrease efficiency, and further burden an already challenging industry. In conclusion, although the FAA's choice was aimed at overseeing national air traffic safety amid resource limitations, it presents a significant obstacle for the commercial space industry. Organizations such as SpaceX, Blue Origin, and similar entities that depend on frequent launches will need to adjust their operations to accommodate a more restricted launch timeframe. This could lead to postponed missions, a slower rollout of satellite networks, and possible hindrances in technological progress. The aerospace field has historically excelled through innovation and determination, yet this latest limitation highlights the reality that even the most sophisticated rockets must comply with the airspace regulations and authorities over them. Whether this predicament proves to be a brief hassle or a persistent challenge will rely on how swiftly both the FAA and the U.S. government can reinstate full functionalities and update the systems that support the future of aviation. The recent FAA rule not only modifies the timeline available for launches, but also affects the overall operational effectiveness and timing of numerous essential missions. For example, missions to the ISS often necessitate exact timing to synchronize with the station's orbit. These launch opportunities are generally brief and occur at designated times throughout the day to guarantee that the spacecraft arrives at the ISS with minimal fuel usage and risk involved. Should the necessary launch window take place during daylight, the FAA's updated regulation would create significant scheduling issues. While NASA missions may receive particular exemptions, the rule still creates a notable challenge for managing coordination and timing, particularly for operations depending on commercial entities like SpaceX.
That's it for today's episode. See you next time.